The last thing I want to show you briefly is the extras. There's galleries, best times, cards, and return. Cards we've seen, that's all the cards that you can get in the game. Best times is obviously how fast you beat in the game. We're the fastest at the moment. And you got gallery. This is basically their little set of boards that they use to design the game. Originally known as food cactus, they got the food health pickups when smacked. But then you had to find the angry cactus to get them. These are all the storyboards and that kind of thing. Why isn't this enemy in the game? Someone really dropped the ball here. Fairly old image used for the homepage. Masked Ruby. This Ruby is a spy. Pictures of all of the monsters in the game. This is Ant-Man's very first ittle do image. These are the little monsters that you fight in the game, or these would have become monsters that you fight in the game. One of the first hand-drawn character sketches. The enemies look more like their original prototype counterparts. This is what happens when Anton has nothing to do. That's a cool image, actually. These characters, like Jenny Bun and Ultrafish Bun 3000, are born from a single sketch and work their way into the game. Coming up with things on the spot constitute most of the rules of development, to the detriment of the quality of the programming. Like the tombstones on the roof of Anton's house, Jenny Bun is technically a tree, only the sprite and hitbox are different. That's pretty cool. Broken fish bun. It'll do. Nils getting fed up with cute games. One can of each year in development. I don't think it was in development for that long. Let's go, Tipsy. That's also a cool image. Swedish Lucia nonsense. I don't know what that is. Keeping a Jenny. Jenny Frog. Jenny Rich, and that's the fox. Joel's Ittle from the prototype. Pinkman Ittle prototype can dance. Anton's first Ittle. First hand-born style concept, not animated. Second try. Finally. You can see that the game had like a very different aesthetic when it was being made. It's magic! Whoosh. Miss, die. The Lickest Turnip. That's one of the bosses. I carved this entire island with my own hands. But you don't have any hands. I lost them in a turnip wars of 54. As revenge, I killed 1,000 turnips with my own two hands. Lies. Guys, stop talking. You don't have any hands either, Ittle. She doesn't really. Nils Island map. We've seen all of this. These are just different enemies. And there's pencil doodles. Little versions of Ittle doing things. The one and only appearance by Mr. Kiwi! God dang. Watch me totally smack this Jenny. Look, his turn of Ice Temple boss. Resurrecting. He didn't resurrect, but I assume that he had different mechanics at some point. Getting the flaming sword. Original pixel style mock-up of the beach. As you can see again, it kind of looked a bit like a Zelda at one point. The original pixel style, at one point this was a playable form. Early art style concept, we never saw anything like this. I'm gonna guess this is Orc Castle. And again, Orc Castle, because we didn't see any Jennies outside the castle. It'll do, lying on a bomb. Tiger Jenny. Scuffed idea of retro minigame. Yeah, I don't know what happened there either. They should have included something like that. That would have been fun. And that's the Genesis on the right. Ultra Fishbun, originally made for Space Hunt. Ultra Fishbun, 3000's first appearance. And on special contribution to the gallery. Daniel's special contribution to the gallery. Lil's special contribution to the gallery. That's a cool picture item. Graphics made for an early trailer. And again, you can see the style isn't quite worked out yet. Two Penguin's enemies didn't make it into the game. Italy connection map. These are the first floors. I guess this is just the castle and all that sort of stuff. Connection map, second floors, hidden caves. The original Italy, now known as the prototype, was made in Game Maker for a school project. Daniel wrote about Game Maker while Joel wrote about compact level design. Graphics were the bottom priority of the project, as you can see. The explosive flaming chainsaw shotgun was also a secret item, obtainable by getting two upgrades out of order. It's not in the game you're playing due to time constraints, but would have made a good reward for the Master Cave, rather than those worthless gallery images. 1,000 years ago, two factions gathered their armies. It was the terrible Jenny Turnip War. The luckiest turnip could not be stopped, rising from the dead when defeated. But Dear Jenny was tough as well. Ceasefire was called. 1,000 years later, a strange rock with a very rich man landed on the island, on the beach. He discovered the descendants of the now historical war, the perfect location for an adventure castle, disrespecting their history. They were varying amounts of thrall to participate. But the mighty Dear Jenny and the concerned live slow as it last approaches. And that's it, all of you. Thank you so much for watching. I've really loved playing this game for you. It's been a blast. And I hope you've had a good time too. We will see you next week when I start playing the next game. I don't know what that is. We'll work it out during the week. Have a great week, folks, and I will see you soon. Goodbye.